sun was going down behind a tattooed tree, and the simple act of a Noah stroke put diamonds in the sea. And all because of the phosphorus there in quantity, as I dug a dig in me in Mexico. There in the valley of Scorpio, beneath the cross of jade, smoking on the seashell pipe the gypsies had made, we sat and we dreamed the while the smugglers bringing wine, that crystal thought time in Mexico.
Not right. Well, I don't know if I believe you. Well, you're pretty persistent, maybe I do.
Without question, the most important knowing ever gifted me by the Sasquatch people is what I refer to as the Love Zap. It is the very foundation of everything I am doing today in trying to educate people about what they are here for at this time. It is at the very core of everything I do as a facilitator and as a representative of my people. I have had many, many powerful lessons and many wonderful experiences. And I don't want to say that they all pale in comparison to this, but as far as importance for us as a people, this is far and away the most powerful lesson. And may I say the most beautiful. Raja Say is the first member of Ari's family that I got to know on a personal and energetic level. I was walking along the forest path one day with my dear friend and mentor, Randy Brisson, and another gentleman. Suddenly, as I was walking along, my senses were assaulted. And I say assaulted in a good way, because it was a beautiful experience. But what happened is I smelt the most beautiful floral fragrance, like a pastel flower fragrance. And it's a fragrance that I've come to know and associate with Raja Say, Ari's daughter. Interestingly enough, Randy Brisson did not smell the fragrance nearly as strong as I did, and the other fellow did not smell it at all. And I suppose that was because it was for me. When I describe what happened to Randy and how my nose, throat, and eyes were burning, which they literally were, it was that strong. He just had that knowing smile on his face and said it was a very good thing. A few short weeks later, I was returning to my car from one of the two gifting areas that I had at the time. And I was almost back when I heard a rustling in the bush just off to my right. And I instantly knew that it was Raja Say. And all of a sudden, I got hit up with what I can only describe as a love zap. It is something that I will never forget. And it was an extremely profound moment. I remember thinking when I experienced it that this is from a universal source. It felt pure, it felt loving. The energy was an energy of no judgment. I didn't feel that I could engage in any of the lower vibrational activities, thoughts, or practices that we people engage in. It was on a very high energetic level, and it was absolutely accepting, loving, and beautiful. And I knew that this is where we as a people had to get to. I knew that instantly. I knew that that was the answer to the conscious shift that people are talking about, the lasting change for mankind. Not only did I feel it, there was also a great download of information associated with it or connected to it. I knew that I was an eternal being. I knew that I had lived many lives. And I knew and I felt the connection to everything. As I made my way back home, I remember that for the next 20 to 30 minutes, I was actually verbally expressing and saying the words, "Oh my, oh my, oh my," over and over again. Such was the impact that this beautiful moment had on me. Its effect was so profound that I recall that I was openly weeping from the beauty of it, from the absolute beauty of it. And to be honest, I've had so many beautiful experiences, holographic visions right before my eyes, things people would consider to be magic, absolutely profound teachings. But my focus has been quite narrow and very directed onto that one universal knowing. And that is that we are all one and all connected. And I feel that my work with them is to spread that universal truth around to others. Personally, I can't imagine a more important work for me to do personally, because this is the one thing, the only thing in my mind that can actually help us to evolve as humans, help us to take that next step, that conscious shift, or however people describe it. Ever since the Love Zap, I have been getting constant reminders from the forest people about the universal truth of all one and all connected. One example that stands out for me is when I accompanied my friend Randy Barnes to a talk that featured four speakers. And it was a day-long talk, and it was actually quite costly. Initially, I bowed out because the subject matter, although moderately interesting, did not justify the cost or the length of the presentation, so I politely declined. However, Randy made it very, very clear how important it was to him that I attended. And I suppose that's because, much like with myself and Randy Brisson, who guided me and gave me so much knowledge and helped me on this walk and helped me to be where I am now, I think that Randy Barnes felt somewhat the same about me, and I just realized how important it was for him that I attend. So I did attend. And it was not long into the first speaker's presentation when I had a eureka moment and I knew exactly why I was there.
He was talking about the pi symbol, which, if I am correct, and I believe I am, he said was a very important religious symbol for many religious disciplines, and that basically it meant God, man, and universe all connected. Well, as soon as I heard that, I was thinking, oh my God, now I know why I'm here, because it just so happens that at that exact time, and for some weeks prior, and ever since, I was receiving a lot of pie glyphs out in the woods on my walks. And that's no coincidence, because when they give you something over and over and over again that's new, or that you recognize, then there's going to be a reason for it. And that was my reason. So I was absolutely amazed that actually enhanced my understanding, or I should say, it validated the all one and all connected knowing that I had with the Love Zap. It was just another validation. And even more remarkable is the fact that the very next day I was drawn to go into the woods. I was pulled to go into the woods and to a certain place. And when I got there, no sooner had I gotten out of my car and taken just a few steps, perhaps a dozen yards, when I came upon a glyph, a beautiful glyph, that featured the pi symbol and a stick man interwoven beautifully together. And there was my answer. There was their confirmation in the beautiful way that they do it, in the no-brainer, hit you over the head with a hammer way that there is just no doubt. The pi symbol and the stick man interwoven together. God, man, and universe, all one and all connected. I think that we humans have a tendency to overthink things and focus too much on the details instead of focusing on the core truth of the matter. That is especially true in the Sasquatch world. We seem to be chasing after the thrills and the magic, but forgetting the basic groundwork and the basic truth of what we have to do. And that is to raise our vibrations and transcend into that state of no judgment and truly evolve as a human race. I think sometimes the details and the excitement of discovery takes precedent over that. And I think that's a mistake. Because in essence, we really have all the knowledge within us anyway. That's what I felt when I was in the midst of the Love Zap, and I had that high energy vibration. I knew that none of that stuff was important. It just wasn't important in the big picture. What was important was knowing that we're all one and all connected, and feeling, that love, that acceptance, that no judgment. I think that sometimes we have to turn off that dialogue that we have in our heads. That dialogue that tells us we're not good enough, or we can't do this, or gives us reasons to put up boxes and exclude people from our lives. People, things, beliefs. all the things that go against us all being connected. This is something that we've been doing ever since we were kids, and we're taught by our parents, we're taught by our peers, we're taught by everybody to put up boxes. When actually, it's a big circle that we should be seeking. The circle of connection. That is why I don't let my thoughts wander too far away from this core truth. Because I know that the best thing that I can do for myself and the best thing we can do for ourselves is to raise our vibrations. I was driving down the street the other day on my way to work, and I was feeling very, very good, and I was in that high vibration. That high vibration of no judgment. It really is a beautiful place to be. It's a peaceful place to be. It's the place I want to always be. But it's a work in progress. It's not a magic pill. But as I was driving along, I started thinking about a particular fella who I perceived was doing things that I didn't agree with and made me mad, and things I considered to be personal against myself. And I noticed that my vibration plummeted from that high, beautiful state to that state of judgment. And the dialogue was going on in my head. And like I said, my vibrations just plummeted. But I turned the dialogue off. Consciously turned it off. And it was a powerful lesson. And one I'm sure that the Sasquatch people initiated. Because they're constantly showing us with examples. Hands-on examples. And others. And when I turned it off, my vibration instantly raised up again. And that's a very powerful point to know, and a very powerful point to make. When you're judging people, and when you have envy and hatred, jealousy, all those negative vibrational things that we practice every day and that we're conditioned to practice, and our go-to things, myself included, it takes us away from where we have to be. And that's the answer. I'm constantly working myself to try to get there and maintain it. I think that I'm there more often now than I used to be, and I am growing. But that to me is the answer. And that is how we are going to evolve as a human race. We will tilt the balance eventually when more and more of us practice being in this higher state. And it's a beautiful thing, and I have a lot of hope that we can get there. But like I said, it's not a magic pill. You have to work at it. Tumbling down.
you feel the need now. Spin the seas around. Ooh, but can you feel the love vibe? Ooh, can you feel the love vibe? Ooh, can you feel the love vibe? Ooh, can you feel the love vibe? I'm talking to the forest. I'm talking from my heart. I'm talking to my people. We're never far apart. For the gift of knowing who I am. But can you feel the love vibe making me feel whole? It's a kind of realization I love the world to know. Can you feel all judgment come on tumbling down? But can't you feel the need now? Spread the love. My people, we're never far apart. I feel the high vibrations, love comes streaming in. Well, thank you for the gift, I know I knew I am. But can you feel the love vibe, making me feel whole? It's a kind of realization, I love the world to know. Can you feel a judgment?